What is going on, Jaguars fans? Welcome back to the Fan Cave, where I am going to continue my series where I break down where I believe the Jaguars are going to look at, what players the Jaguars are going to look at, rather, in the 2021 NFL Draft. I've done rounds 1, 2, and 3. This is going to be round 4. We've got 2 picks in the 4th round, and I believe this is, there's a lot of still a lot of open doors here, but we're kind of getting into the best player available territory. We're not all the way there yet, but I do believe the Jaguars can fill a couple of needs with filling in the depth chart in the 4th round. Let's get right into it. Starting us off at pick number 106, we're going to start off the top of the 4th round with Walker Little out of Stanford. Plays offensive tackle, and honestly, Tony Pauline of the Draft Network has stated that he has incredible footwork. He has incredible vision when he's in pass protection sets. It's only there's the gaps in his game whenever he's having to actually be a run blocking tackle. Now, I've talked about how much George Warhop is going to mean to this offensive line and the youth on the offensive line. And I believe Walker Little can develop immensely from George Warhop's mentorship. And honestly, I'd much rather see someone struggle in run protection than pass protection. I feel like having to learn how to kick and how to get your feet right with pass protection is a whole heck of a lot different than just essentially, I'm a stronger, bigger man than you, and I'm going to run right through you. I'm going to make a hole and get this running back through the gap. You know, run protection just seems like you put a little bit more weight on, you slap him on the ass, and you get him going. If he doesn't, he's a great depth. You know, he can be that. He can be the rotational tackle in the event that Cam Robinson or Jawan Taylor go down. And he can also, you know, he can also kick inside a little bit and play a little bit of guard. And Walker Little, it would be a great addition to the Jacksonville Jaguar depth chart on the offensive line, to say the least. Now, another player on this list is, he plays a position that I believe we just need to start throwing players at this problem. The Jaguars have not been able to figure it out. I've said on numerous occasions, the Jaguars have the Mount Rushmore of failed free agents at this position. That's the tight end position. You know, you look at Austin Seferian Jenkins. You look at Julius Thomas, Tyler Eifert, the list goes on and on and on at the tight end position that we failed to bring in a quality player at the position. Now, Pat Freiermuth, you know, Brevin Jordan, if they aren't available, even if they are available, we take them. I believe the Jaguars are going to continue to look to essentially load the tight end cannon and just continue to blast this problem with players until they find one that works. And the next one that I believe they're going to load into the cannon is the tight end out of Ole Miss, Kenny Yeboah. He's a fifth-year senior. You know, he played a lot of time at Kansas, ends up going to Ole Miss, and has essentially a record year. Really, really helps out his draft stock. You know, over 1,000 yards throughout his career. I believe 18 touchdowns, 12 touchdowns rather, 74 catches. Now, big thing with Kenny Yeboah is that he is only really your wide receiver. He's just a big, big wide receiver. He is not going to offer you anything in the runner pass blocking game. He is going to be that, you know, middle of the field threat, and that's about it. He is not going to be anyone that you look for to actually be the 6th offensive lineman in a set. So Kenny Yeboah has potential. Whether or not the Jaguars pull the trigger on Kenny Yeboah is up in the air. I'm indifferent on him. If he becomes a Jaguar, great. I'd love to see him have success. If he doesn't, okay. I hope he has success with another franchise. Kenny Yeboah he's indifferent for me, to say the least. Now, another player that I believe the Jaguars are going to look at pick 106 is the defensive tackle out of UCLA, Osa Odighizuwa. Sorry, I had to reference my notes there for a second just because that's a heck of a name. You know, you look at Yannick Ngakoue, you think that's a crazy name. Imagine adding Osa Odighizuwa to the team. Osa, 120 tackles, 11 and a half sacks throughout his 4 years at University of California at Los Angeles. And I believe that shows a lot of, he's a great run stuffer, you know, 30 tackles a season, 2, 3, 4 sacks a season. And That shows a lot that he's consistent. That's what you want out of a defensive tackle. You're not looking for great splash plays, really, out of your big uglies in the defensive line, that where their job is to stop the run. That is what he's here for. And another great ability to him is that he can also be that big end. And he's not too big where he's pretty much just locked into that nose tackle spot and the 3-4. He can also play that big end and get after the quarterback, as it shows with his 11 and a half sacks, on top of his 27 and a half tackles for a loss, you know, he has a knack for getting behind the getting into the backfield, harassing the quarterback, harassing running backs, and just being a menace in the trenches. Oso Odighizuwa would be a great addition to this team in the fourth round if he's there. I can see him going as early as the third, honestly, because those are some great stat lines, and he's a menace to society on that defensive line, to say the least. He's gonna be a great addition to whatever team he goes to. I just hope that ends up in the teal and black around the pick 106, maybe ends up going to 130, but at the same time, I wouldn't be upset with him around a 65, even in the third round. Now, to say that Trevor Lawrence doesn't have enough weapons is always going to be the truest statement you can ever say. You can never go wrong with adding more weapons to an offense. And I believe the wide receiver out of the University of Houston, Marquez Stevenson, would be a great addition to this team. Now, the only downside with him is that he hasn't really had a whole season to really show what he can be throughout the length of a season. He has missed games and missed time throughout every season he's played in Houston. But with numbers like 147 to over 2,200 yards and 22 touchdowns, that you can't go wrong with looking at that and saying that's a heck of a playmaking wide receiver. If the Jaguars do look his way, you know, around pick 130, closer going into the fifth, I won't be upset with this pick because, you know, you take a flyer on a potentially injured wide receiver. And almost like a Caleb Farley, you know, sliding down draft boards. If he didn't have the injury concerns, he's definitely up higher. But Marquez Stevenson out of the University of Houston would not be a bad pickup and to bring him into the teal and black. And if he does become a Jaguar, I'll be ecstatic about it. He's a great playmaking wide receiver. But at the same time, those injury concerns, they're there. And I wouldn't be upset if the Jaguars said, you know what, let's look at someone that isn't as injured and doesn't have the history of injuries as Marquez Stevenson. Now, rounding out this list with the 130th pick in the fourth round, the Jacksonville Jaguars, I believe, are going to look at potentially adding, you know, some linebacker depth. There's a lot of question marks around Quincy Williams, Shaq Quarterman. What are they going to offer in the linebacking depth and also the linebacking room? I believe the Jaguars can look at Monty Rice out of the University of Georgia, four-year starting linebacker who had just under 220 tackles, 10 and a half of which went for tackles for loss. That shows that he has the ability to be that great run-stuffing linebacker. Now, the only downside is when plays do get to the outside, he does not really have that great, you know, show-stopping lateral speed that you want to see out of a potential linebacker. But he can crush downhill. He will start cracking heads inside the tackles. If you meet him in the hole, I feel bad for you. And Monty Rice would be a great addition, you know, potentially be the heir apparent to Joe Schobert whenever Joe Schobert does eventually leave Jacksonville. If he does leave Jacksonville, who knows? He might end up having a career like Paul Posluszny, starting off in one city and really just finishing out his entire NFL tenure in Jacksonville. Without a doubt, Monty Rice would be great depth pickup for the middle linebacker spot and for the linebacking core as a whole. All right, Jaguars fans, that is round four. Now, we've done rounds one, two, three. This is number four. Be sure to subscribe as it gets you entered to win a signed Fred Taylor jersey. Let me say that again. All you have to do is subscribe to the channel and you get added into a giveaway to win a signed Fred Taylor jersey. Giveaway ends on draft night whenever Roger Goodell announces Trevor Lawrence will become the new quarterback of your Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, it's a great giveaway. I'm excited for it. I'm excited to add a great piece of memorabilia to any of your fan caves. And as always, stay safe and go Jaguars.